Welcome back students to our online platform, that is our school's YouTube channel. So again we are ready with today's video. This video is for class 10, subject maths and chapter number 2. This is chapter number 2 and the chapter name is polynomial. As yesterday I told you that polynomial is an algebraic expression having many terms. Poly means many, mals means terms. So today we will discuss how to find the zeros of a polynomial, zeros or roots of the polynomial or the solution of the polynomial. So today we will discuss how to find roots, solution or zeros of a quadratic polynomial. A quadratic polynomial is given, that is x square plus 7x plus 12. This polynomial is given. If you want to find the zeros of the polynomial or solution of the polynomial, then we are supposed to put equals to 0. Now we are supposed to factorize the polynomial by splitting the middle term. So we will split the middle term. Now how we split it, that you know. We are supposed to split in such a way that 3x plus 4x, 7x, and the multiplication of these two numbers should be the constant term, 4, 3, the 12. So now what we will do, we will take the common from here, x is common, so we have taken x common, remaining is x plus 3. From here, plus 4 common, remaining is x plus 3 equals to 0. So here we will get the same. In the bracket, within the bracket, we will get the same expression. So now this is common. What we will do? X plus 3 taken common, and what is remaining here? X here plus 4. So if this expression equals to 0, so either this bracket will be 0 or this bracket will be 0. One of the brackets should be 0. So if x plus 3 equals to 0, it implies x equals to minus 3, and or x plus 4 is equals to 0, तो ये 0 है, ये 0 है, तो x की value minus 3, या फिर हमारा ये 0 है, ये वाला 0 हो जाता है, x plus 4 equals to 0, then it implies that x is equals to minus 4. So these are the two zeros or two solutions or two roots of this quadratic equation. We are supposed to keep in mind what is the degree of this equation, that is 2. So we will get two roots. Degree is 2, the values of x is 2. Now some relation is also there between the coefficient and the roots of the polynomial. General form of a quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus c. A is the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of x, and c is the constant term. Here a is equals to kuch bhi nahi hai, means 1. Okay, yahan pe kuch nahi hota, wahan pe 1 hota, 1x square. So a ki value kitni ho gayi? 1. B ki value 7. C, the value of c is 12. So the zeros of a quadratic equation can be represented by alpha and beta are the roots. Roots means the solution of zeros, and alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a, alpha into beta is equal to c upon a. This is the relation between the roots and the coefficient of the polynomial. So from here, now we have to verify. Alpha plus beta. Alpha is minus 3 plus minus 4, that is equals to minus 7. Alpha into beta, that is minus 3 into minus 4, minus minus plus, that is 12. Now we will verify the relation from here. From here, alpha plus beta it equals to minus b upon a. B is 7 upon 8, a is 1, means minus 7. So this is verified. Minus 7 is there, minus 7 is here. Now again alpha into beta c upon a. What is the value of c? The value of c is 12. What is the value of a? The value of a is 1. So 12 upon 1, that is 12. Again, that is verified. From here, alpha beta is plus 12. From here, alpha beta is plus 12. In this way, we can find out the zeros of the polynomial of quadratic polynomial. And we can verify the relation between the zeros and the coefficient of the polynomial. So, how to find the zeros of quadratic polynomial? By splitting the middle term. So this is the question for today. I hope that you will search this kind of questions in your book and you will try to solve them as well. If you have not arranged the books, you are supposed to arrange as early as possible so that we can move forward in a proper way. Thank you. Thank you very much.